Hello friends, welcome to TYS. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel, we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services. And for this purpose, we have started MCQ series of different topics like Ancient India, Medieval India, Modern India, Environment and Ecology, etc. So what we are doing in this series, we cover daily 5 questions of each topic. And we will continue to do so till 31st May. So, for example, today is the lecture number 42 of Environment and Ecology, and we will practice 5 questions of this also. So, in this way, we will cover the top other topics as well, like Ancient India, Medieval India, and Modern India. So, daily 5 questions of each topic are covered. So, if you go by a calculation, then approximately by 31st May, we will have covered 1100 to 1200 questions of each topic. And we will end this series only on 31st May. So why the date chosen has been 31st May? Because your prelims is scheduled on 2nd June and we will end this series only one day before your prelims. So if you want to be confident in your preparation, then do follow us and do follow these questions and explanations of these. Because let me tell you friends, some students think that they haven't read the environment and ecology and then they will not attempt the test or the MCQs. But let me tell you friends that this is wrong approach, because the mostly students think that first they will read and then they will attempt. But I suggest you to read and attempt the test simultaneously. In this approach, what happens is that you encounter new concepts by doing tests. And when you encounter new concepts, obviously, if you haven't read environment and ecology, then there will be certain concepts, even if they are so simple, too simple to be ignored. But you will be not able to attempt them. But you will certainly read about them. So obviously, you will have the idea of these topics when you will read the standard book about the environment and ecology. So friends, in this way, what happens? A kind of approach is added to your study. When you read earlier, you simply read it, and you don't know which information has to be picked and which information has not to be picked, and you just go through the book. So that reading is not that much comprehensive. But when you do combine these things, that is testing part and reading part, then a kind of approach is added to your study, and you study from the angle of exam. That means you study from the perspective of the exam, and you also notice the important concepts that are to be picked up while reading. So that makes your reading more effective than just doing reading only. So do attempt all the tests simultaneously while doing the reading. So this is all about the UPSC, because test is very important part of UPSC preparation. So let's start our discussion. The first question is, carbon dioxide released in the atmosphere creates a greenhouse effect by. So friends, we all know that carbon dioxide is a greenhouse gas, and it causes global warming. And how it happens is this question have been asked to us. So A is trapping the heat radiated from the earth. B is trapping direct solar insolation. C is aiding conduction of heat in atmosphere. D is capturing the ultraviolet portion of light. So let me tell you friends that the carbon dioxide that is released in atmosphere, it creates greenhouse effect by trapping the heat radiated from earth. So the A option is correct option. So let me provide you the explanation. So carbon dioxide cannot trap the direct solar radiation that is coming to earth, because it is of short wavelength and it can absorb only long wavelength. And that's why only when this radiation comes into our atmosphere, and when this certain part of it is absorbed by earth, and then earth releases it this energy back in the form of long wave radiation. And what the carbon dioxide does, it absorbs the long wave radiation that is radiated by earth, and it comes in excited state. And when it comes in excited state, it releases that energy. So some part of it goes back into the space, and some is added into the atmosphere. So in this way, the global warming happens. That is by absorbing the long wave terrestrial radiation by the carbon dioxide. So this long wave basically is released by the long wave terrestrial radiation is released by the earth So this is in this way the global warming and the greenhouse takes place. So obviously the C option, D option is wrong because the UV rays are not captured by carbon dioxide, but this process is done by the ozone layer. And also heat conduction is done not is done by contact of air with surface of Earth and not by the carbon dioxide. So option C is also wrong. And also friends, let me tell you that carbon dioxide cannot trap the direct solar radiation because it is of short wavelength. So option B is also wrong. So carbon dioxide can only absorb wavelength that is longer than 4000 nanometers. So this is about the explanation part. So the correct option is A. So friends, before moving on to the second question, let me explain you that we will provide the explanation of only first question, and regarding the next questions, we will provide you only the solution. Because friends, earlier what we used to do, we used to do the we used to provide the explanation of all the questions. But after the demand of certain students, that is those who are our paid subscribers, we have introduced a change. We provide the explanation of only first question so that you people can have the idea that whether the channel that is covering these topics, whether that is up to the level of UPSC or not. So for that purpose, for clearing your doubt, we add the explanation to the first question so that you can judge us that whether we are following the UPSC pattern or not, because it is much important. Because if you are preparing for UPSC, then you certainly have to solve the questions from the UPSC perspective. So this is a kind of, you can say, a sample explanation of a sample question. And for if you want the explanation of other questions, that is the questions that we now cover, you will have to subscribe to our PDFs of explanations. So there is very very minimum amount that we have kept for this purpose, that is rupees 50 for the entire course of environment and ecology. So for the entire course till 31st May, for the entire PDFs, that is for the 1100 to 1200 questions that we will cover, you will have to make a single time payment of rupees 50, that is 50. So we are not charging you much. This is for the purpose of your affordability as well as for the purpose of our motivation. So let's move on to the second question. The second question is, disinfection of drinking water in rural areas can be done with the help of which of the following natural herbs? So friends, in rural areas that are remote, the rural areas that are poor, they are not much, they cannot afford the kind of we can say the costly cleaning drinking water processes. So that's why they use traditional methods. And which of the following natural herbs has been used is can be used for this purpose? This has been asked in question. So first is neem, second is tulsi, third is garlic. So let me tell you friends, first neem and second tulsi, both these can be used for the purpose of disinfection of drinking water in rural areas. But let me tell you friends that certain pollutants in water cannot be disinfected by this neem and tulsi. So they are effective on certain pollutants only. So they have to be kind of complemented with other remedies also. So the C, correct answer is C, that is 1 and 2 only. So the explanation in detail that why the garlic is not is provided in the PDF explanation. So in the PDF which is specially prepared from the explanation perspective. So third question is, strip cropping method involves. So here we have been asked, what is strip cropping? A is cutting strips up and down the slope to form channels for quick flow of irrigation water. B, establishing sand dunes in and around the crop in dry regions. C is cropping different crops in alternate rows to reduce soil erosion. D is leaving strips of grass to grow between the crops. So let me tell you friends that the D statement is correct. So the correct answer is D, and the explanation in detail is provided in the explanation PDF. So let's move on to the fourth question. So friends, there is a plant called Himalayan Yew. So it is a medicinal plant that is found in Himachal Pradesh, parts of Himachal Pradesh and Arunachal Pradesh, and it has been declared endangered by the IUCN under its red list. So we have been asked here that why it is endangered, why, what is the threat to it. So first statement is depletion of interspecies gene bank of yew. Second is threat of biopiracy. Third is soaking of groundwater in areas where it is present. So we have been asked we have to judge that whether which of the following three are the plausible reasons for the kind of threatened condition of Himalayan yew, endangered condition of Himalayan yew. So let me tell you friends that none of these statements is correct, and none of these is responsible for the endangered status of Himalayan yew. So the correct option is D, that is none of the above. So the explanation isn't the explanation PDF itself. So let's move on to the fifth question. The fifth question is, multi-purpose river projects can pose which of the following environmental and geological problems? So you know that friends, we nowadays construct multi-purpose projects, river projects, that is dams and other irrigation projects, for the purpose of expansion of irrigation and also for the generation of power. So that's why they are called multi-purpose, because they have a kind of multi-purpose in their construction. So there are certain disadvantages that are associated with these multi-purpose river projects, and we have to analyze these kind of disadvantages. So the first statement is triggering earthquakes. Second is excessive sedimentation of riverbed. Third is making migration difficult for fishes. So let me tell you friends that all these three disadvantages are associated with multi-purpose river projects. So they trigger earthquakes, because friends, when you will stop the flow of river, then certainly collection of immense quantity of water will certainly create the pressure on the hill on which it is, or on which it is kind of it is stored. So certainly the rocks will bear the pressure, but obviously when every rock has the cracks in it. So when these cracks come under pressure, the water acts as a lubricant, and it triggers earthquakes. So the first statement is correct, and also friend, second statement is correct, because when you will stop the river flow, then obviously what happens beyond the we can say beyond the dam gates, the sediment will be accumulated, because the kinetic energy due to which it is flowing will not be there, because the water has to be stopped by the gates. So in this way, the sediments that are carried, they are stored on the riverbed, and this condition also leads to floods in the rainy season. So this also poses a problem. So third is also friends correct, because certain fishes, they are dependent upon the migration for their life cycle. So when we interfere in their life processes, and this creates their migration difficult by the dam gate. So all of the above statements are correct. So the D option is correct. And further explanation that what are the advantages and other disadvantages of the multi-purpose projects, you can subscribe to our PDF explanation part. So for subscribing to that, you have to just WhatsApp us at this number, that is 8968426481. So daily we are covering 5 questions, and approximately 1100 questions will be covered. And friends, we are providing you these PDFs, entire PDFs, till 31st May by making a single time payment of rupees 50. That means you have to just make a single time payment of rupees 50, and you can subscribe to all these PDFs that we will be providing till 31st May. So it is very minimum amount that we have kept for the purpose of your affordability and the purpose of our motivation. So friends, these are not just 1100 questions, because as you know that UPSC is not that you have solved a question and you have noticed its answer and your work is over. Friends, UPSC is about clearing of concepts. So concepts can only be cleared if you know that why a particular option is correct and why a particular option is incorrect. So in that case, we in the explanation PDFs also provide the explanation of the questions that of the options that are not correct. So in a way, you are not getting 1100 questions. You are getting, if you see that in each question there are four alternatives, then you are getting 4400 concepts. So obviously you are preparing in a comprehensive manner. So there are other courses as well that we have on our channel. Let me explain about them to you, that we have environment series already, about which I have told you, that if you want to subscribe to the explanation PDFs of these this series you can you have to pay a make a single time payment of rupees 50, and there is ancient India for which we charge rupees 100, and then there is medieval India part for the explanation PDF for which we charge 100, and also for modern India we charge 100. So the total amounts to rupees 350. So the students who want to subscribe to them in a package manner, what we are doing, we are offering them a discount of rupees 75, and you can get all these PDFs. If you are subscribing to them in a package format, you can get all them in rupees 275. That is 75 rupees will be discounted to you. So why, friends, it is important to subscribe to these PDFs? Because at the end of the day, when you will not be able to revise the revise by the way of seeing videos, because you will not have that much of time to see the videos that are 50 to 20 minute long, and also there are other concepts also that you will have to cover at that time, like history, polity, geography, economy, science and tech, and government programs, India yearbook, current affairs, and also then economic survey. So also you, at that time you will not have the time to read bulky books because they cannot be read at that time due to the limitation of time. So what UPSC is basically, you in UPSC your basic concepts must be clear, your important concepts must be clear, and they must be revised, and they must be properly revised multiple times, and the time consumption for them must be as less as possible. So friends, these five things decide your selection in the UPSC exam. So the basic concepts are covered from NCERTs, and the important concepts are covered from your standard books. And friends, let me tell you that you can't read NCERTs again and again. At the most, you can read them two times. And similarly, in case of important concepts also, you can cover them at the most two times. So revision then becomes monotonous, because when you have read a particular book for the first time, you had the interest in that book. But you have read it second time, then also you have the interest in it. But reading it third time becomes a boring task. So revision, and this creates problem in your revision. And when you don't do revision, then it creates problem in your preparation, and your morale comes to a takes downward turn. So for this purpose, we are making these MCQ series in such a way that you revise your whole topic in such a manner that the basic concepts are also covered and important concepts are also covered. Because when you do the practice, do the revision by question answer format, then you first read the question, and then you a kind of interest or curiosity arises in you about the what is the answer of it. And if you know its answer, and if you mark it incorrect, then also the curiosity rises that where I am wrong. So that then you will read the explanation of that part which is wrong, that which you have attempted wrongly. So in this way you can do your revision in an interesting manner, and when certain thing becomes interesting, and then that can be done multiple times. And obviously when you do a particular thing multiple times, then it takes your less time, because you have done it repeatedly. So this is the benefit of our PDF. So if you want to subscribe to them, you can WhatsApp us at this number, that is 8968426481. So lastly, friends, let me also tell you that we have a Telegram channel also, the link of which I have provided in the description box. And those students who don't know how to join our Telegram channel, let me tell you that there is a link that I have provided in the description box. And there is an app called eSandesh, and you have to install that app. And by installing this app, what have you? It is. Let me tell you that, friends, it is totally free of cost. There is no cost of downloading it, and you can download it. And when you will download it, what you have to do, you have to copy and paste the link of my channel here in the search box that you are seeing in the on your screen that I have encircled. So when you will paste the link here, you will get to my channel, and in this way you can remain updated with all the initiatives that we are running. So if you want to remain updated and want to get all the notifications, you can join our channel. So friends, this is all about today's lecture. Thank you very much, and please, friends, don't forget to subscribe our channel, and also please don't forget to press the bell icon if you want the notification of all the important updates that we are doing on our YouTube channel. So thank you.